Hello everyone, welcome to the Smarty Techie. In today's topic we are learning how we are going to convert a standalone to the replica set members. Then we will check how to maintain a connection between the replica sets. So this is basically the video all about the replica set members, that how we are going to use it and how we are going to create members in it, how we are going to change our MongoDB instances to the replica set members, and further by proceeding this topic we will check in next video that how we are going to connect to the MongoDB replica set members in Java application. So you can please stay tuned with me so that you can be able to check this topic. Okay, so before this you can check that in my channel you can check this playlist that I have already given some examples, some tutorials how to connect to the Mongo using connection string URI format. These connections are for the standalone server. So in the next video we are going to connect using the replica set members. So this is about the standalone servers or your local host to connection string, and with enabled auth or without authorization. They are both. I have given both the examples. So let's go with the topic. And firstly, how we are converting our standalone server. My standalone server is my local host MongoDB server. If you are using any application or any server that is containing any other IP, for example in localhost IP will be 127 dot or something like that, and 127.0.1, and for the other server IPs maybe it will be containing 20.80.60.40, something like this IP servers. So if you are using any standalone server, you may go with this topic. Okay, in the documentation given by the mongodb.com, you can check they have given you the documentation for converting the standalone to the replica set. How we are going to use it? Firstly you have to shut down your Mongo instance. Either you can use the shutdown command of the Mongo, or you can stop the service. MongoDB stop. So my MongoDB instances has been stopped, and further you can run this command. What this command is saying that, okay, this is the MongoD, that is, it is a Mongo based command, and prefix for this command, this is a port that on which port my MongoDB is running. This is a DB path. What is the DB path and how you are going to find it? That if you are going to your, if you will go to EVM ATC MongoD conf, you can check your DB path is given here, and you may proceed. If you want to change your DB path, you may change in this configuration file too. So whatever whichever you are using your DB path, please proceed with this. So here is my DB path, and this is the command. If you want to change your MongoDB instance to a replica set member, so you have to write this command, that is --replset replica set, and this is the name of the replica set that you want to give it. For example, my replica set name is RS1, This is the bind IP. Bind IP by default it will be local host. So I am also using my local host system. I will be proceed with this. If you have another IPs, you may give your hostname and IP address after comma. So let's start our MongoDB instance with the replica set member. One more thing, if you will go before converting your MongoDB instance to the replica set, if you want to check that if your Mongo is running with your replica set or not, you can go with the Mongo command, enter your Mongo shell, then write this command rs.status. This command will give you the status of the replica set members, that which one is primary, is they are healthy or not, how many members in your replica sets, and if it is not enabled in your server, then it will be giving you the error as not running with replica sets, not replication enabled. So we are going to enable our replica set members. Okay, it's giving you the exception as illegal operation attempting to create a log file on a read only directory. This state db path is the read only directory. That means to write over it, the permission is given to only the sudo user. So what you have to do is you have to run this command using the sudo command. So I have run this command using the sudo mongod. The same command which is given in the website, using the sudo command you have to give your password here, then you will check that these are coming on your screen. After that your screen will be going to end with this this line, that is waiting for the connection on port 27017. That means your replica has been set, and what you have to do, you have to run your MongoDB instances and then enter your Mongo shell. Then what you have to do is start your service, start your Mongo instance, service MongoD start. I'll do this service MongoD start. I have started my MongoDB server. You have to enter your Mongo shell. Now when you will enter your Mongo shell, you will check check that these lines will be coming on your screen, that connection accepted from this server, that this is my on server, that is the localhost server, and the client which I am using to connect is the MongoDB shell. If you will going to connect using your RoboMongo, RoboTT, MongoChef, you will get your you will get the connection as well in this client metadata. If you perform any of the queries, now you can perform any of the queries using the replica set members. So we have already set up our replica set member or replica set on our standalone MongoDB. So now what we have to do, we have to check that if it has been set up or not using the rs.status. So before setting our replica set, you will find that this was giving the error as not running with the replica set. Now it's giving you the status as rs.initiate if not get done for the set. I'll tell you what we have to do for this. No replica set config has been received. that it means that you have set up the replica set, but no members has been given, no initiation has been given to the replica set members. So what you have to do, you have to run this command rs.initiate. Now you will check, firstly it has been turning into the secondary. As it has only one member, so it will convert into the primary replica set members. So now this is the primary and secondary definitions are giving there, that now this server has been converted into the replica set members. So what the difference between the primary and the secondary replica set? For example, firstly I'll go how you are going to add a member to a replica set members. Using the rs.add command, you can add another member into this, and what you have to do, you have to set up your another MongoDB server. You have to convert these members, that another member, to the replica set members too. And after that you have to add like rs.add, for example I have another member or another Mongo running on another port. For example, 270.87. So what does that mean? If you enter this, then it will get added to the RS members, replica set members. And after that, you have to give. If you want to give to set the priority, you can provide the priority and votes over there. And after that, you have to run the rs.status. If rs.status has been running on your system, it will give you the list of all the members. That I have only one member, so that's why it's giving you the one member as a primary. And if you want to give another member, it will give you as the secondary state. In the replica set members, there are two states, that is the replica and that is the primary and secondary. One is the arbitrary member as well. I will tell you after in another video. Firstly, what does the primary mean? The primary means the all the write operations should be done. It must be done using the primary set members. No writing commands will be allowed in your secondary set members. So you can do all the queries, read or write, using primary, but not on the secondary replica set. So this is the difference between the primary and the secondary replica set. So we have learned in this video, that how to convert our standalone local system, local standalone server, to the replica set members using the command. In the next video, we will learn how to convert these two replica set using a configuration file. So before this, you can like and subscribe my channel, and bye bye, take care.